everybody, it's Seth Rudetsky, and today we are going to deconstruct scooping. Not ice cream scooping, though just as delicious. What do I mean by scooping? Okay, so scooping is like, first of all, I always talk about like 80s riffing, like, because you know, nowadays everything is like, like 45 notes, but in my day, we just scooped a step. So instead of, you know, sometimes I wonder, our amazing riffs were, sometimes I wonder, we all learned to scoop like a step, and that was kind of like the big like 80s riff. And it sounds annoying, but actually scooping is delicious when done correctly. I'm going to start with somebody who taught me how to scoop back in the early 70s. I'm talking about Carol Dimas. Carol Dimas, for those of you that grew up in the East Coast, was the original host with Paula of Magic Garden. It's nice to say hello, hello, or see ya, hope you had a good, good time. Donna. I grew up loving that TV show. Carol was also the original Sandy Dombrowski in Grease, brunette. As opposed to Olivia Newton-John, who was blonde, and now every Sandy has to be blonde. Back in my day, she was brunette. Any to the who. She didn't just scoop a step. She scoops, like, a fourth? This is her in Summer Nights. So, She goes, instead of going, met up, first of all, it would be written, met up boy, cute as can be. And instead of going, met up boy, she goes, met up boy, cute as can be. Summer days, drifting away. She actually scoops down a minor third. Summer days, up a step, drifting away to the summer nights. So she's scooping like up a fourth, down a fifth. That's what I love. It's not just like a little tiny half step. It's full meta boy, cute as I love it so much. Here we go. Okay. Oh, I gotta go back. 1 second. Go to the beginning. Hit it.
Meta girl, crazy for me.
Summer day, drifting away to all the summer nights.
Lydia fifth. So then the next time she scoops, she'll actually do just a pulse. Here and by, actually maybe it's a step. Here and by me, a fourth. Got my suit damp. Instead of got my suit damp, got my suit damp. I just love it. It's so much moving around the map. And then, he showed off, splashing around. Here, listen.
She swam by me, she got a cradle.
He ran by me, got off my suit and
saved a life, she gave me
round. He showed off, splashing around.
There's so many notes going on. By the way, on a total side note, you know the original RZA was Adrienne Barbeau? If you were a Maud fan like I was, Maud's daughter. For some reason, everyone copies the movie version of Grease, and they always do the sassy Sprechstimme, Rizzo, because it sounds like a drag. In my day, the album I grew up on, the original Grease cast album, Adrienne Barbeau goes up to the E flat. It's so much better than because it sounds like a drag. She actually belts it. Please listen to this.
Tell me more, but you don't have to brag.
Tell me more, because it sounds like a drag.
Thank you. She goes to the E flat. Can we stop with this? Spoken version, can be all from every future Rizzo, every Rizzo listening right now, can you please belt the E-flat from now on? Thank you. Okay, one more thing I want you to hear that Carol Dimas says that's so good. He was sweet, just turned 18. I love it. She goes, ooh, he was sweet. She has like a sense memory of how sweet he is. She's like, ooh, he was sweet. I love that. And then she sounds so good on the C, just turned 18. She holds it for so long. Great vibrato, great placement. Listen to this. Okay, here we go.
He got friendly, holding my hand. Well, she got friendly, down in the sand.
Now listen.
Oh, sweet, just turned 18.
So good. All right, bravo, Carol Dimas. Now, like I said, I'm focusing on scooping. So I'm going from Grease. I'm going all the way now to Rags, Lonnie Price. Now, on a side note, obsessed with Lonnie Price, and you should be too, because he put together this great documentary called The Best Thing That Ever Could Have Happened, but the best worst thing that ever could have happened, which is about the making of Merrily Roll Along. Now, the number one documentary in the country. So, bravo, Lonnie Price, bravo, film, and you've got to see it and support documentaries about Broadway shows, so more of them are going to be made. So this is Lonnie when he was in Rags. So a couple things I want you to hear about this. Wait, Lonnie Price, one. Okay, here we go. So Rags, if you don't know, it's by Charles Strauss and Stephen Schwartz. Devastatingly, a very, very short-lived show, open and closed basically in a weekend. But I'm telling you, one of the best scores ever, ever written for Broadway. It's an amazing score. And this song is between Lonnie Price and this young kid named Josh Blake. Josh was like 10 years old, and he did two short-lived, basically shows that opened and closed in a weekend, in a row in the mid-80s. He did The Human Comedy and Rags. Sounds so good on both albums, and then never did another show again. And I actually wanted to come back to Broadway. I tried to track him down. I actually went to Facebook, and I was like trying to find Josh Blake. There are a lot of Jews out there. A lot of Josh Blakes, Josh Blake Steins. Point is, cannot find this Josh Blake, but I want him back on Broadway. His voice is so great. So in this scene, you know, Rags takes place in the early 1900s. It's about immigrants coming to New York, and Lonnie's like a pushcart salesman of a gramophone. And he and Josh is like his little sidekick, they're trying to sell this gramophone, and this woman gets intrigued because Josh is saying, I'm making it for my mother, and she's like, oh, I have a son, and you know, maybe I'll buy a gramophone for myself. Okay, so here, listen to this part of the song, and then I'm going to deconstruct more, but I want you to first just hear this section. Here we go.
Mama, that little boy, he was singing about
me. He's making a record.
For my mother.
The woman.
For your mother?
Yes, she's
very sick.
That's Lonnie.
She feels terrible.
Terrible.
Lying all alone.
So alone.
Crying because her boy is gone. But on her gramophone,
yes,
she owns a gramophone. She hears his voice.
She loves my voice.
And in his voice, she finds the what?
The will, the courage.
Yes, the courage to go on and on and on.
Now, I'm focusing on that. First of all, isn't it a great song? I want you to hear Lonnie's yes! Because I decided that it's an homage to himself, which was an homage to somebody else. Here, first listen to the yes. Here we go.
And in his voice she finds the
what, the will, the courage.
Yes!
I decided, okay, have you seen my deconstruction of Opening Doors, like my favorite song from Merrily, Roll Along? There's one moment where Jim Walton is singing about this idea he has, he wants to do the show, and he's describing all the different things in the show, and Lonnie is supposed to say yeah. But Lonnie goes, yeah! He does this crazy high-pitched yeah, and in the deconstruction, I just say, for some reason, I said, Lonnie Price does his yeah up the octave. And I just said, it's so weird to me that he does this really high-pitched yeah. And that was it. After I did the deconstruction, Lonnie contacted me. And he was like, oh my God. He said, you notice my yeah. He said, turns out that was his homage. He was obsessed with Sweeney Todd. And that was his private homage to Angela Lansbury. He thought that yeah kind of sounded like Angela as Mrs. Lovett. And he did it kind of as a, not as a joke, but he did it in rehearsal just for himself, and he's like, oh my God, they're going to cut it, and no one ever noticed it, no one ever cut it, and he just kept it. That's why on the album he's like, yeah, because he thinks it sounds like Mrs. Lovett. I guess it does. Here, listen. Wait, not play next. Here. Rude. Why does my iTunes give me attitude?
What? Where? Why? When? Not just song, the story, scenes, piano pieces, why?
Frankly, Frank.
Come on. Does that sound like Mrs. Lovett one more time?
What? Where? Why? When? Not just song, the story, scenes, piano pieces, why?
So then I decided the more mature version of that is...
And in his voice she finds the
what, the will, the courage,
yes!
Is it? You tell me. Any to the who. Okay, so now I want to keep going on the Rags. So, and now we're going to get into the actual scooping. First of all, Rags in the mid-80s. And what's so sad to me is in the mid-80s, to me, orchestras were cut down from the actual 50s. But now, like... Are there orchestras on Broadway? Now it's always like a rhythm section with a violin. Oh, so devastating to me. But back in the 80s, we still basically had orchestras. So I want you to just hear the really cool violins. Dick, dick, a dom. Amazing violin part. Just a great orchestration. And then on top of that, I want you to hear how creative it is. The woman asks what price it is, and the trumpets do this weird flutter thing because it's like, I'm nervous about if something's expensive. So just listen how creative it is. First, it's great violins, and then trumpets being like, price, is this going to be expensive? Here we go.
What's the will, the courage?
Yes! The courage to go on and on and on.
That sounds wonderful.
Doesn't it?
It's really wonderful. How much did you say that it was?
Did you hear that? How much did you say that it was? And the trumpets are like, how much? Listen, it's so creative.
Really wonderful.
Wasn't it?
How much did you say that it was?
$25.
So creative.
Yes, but...
Okay, so now we get into some scooping. Lonnie does this fast, you're gonna hear fast like the birds above. Then he goes, one special sound, here is the sound, hark to the sound. I just love that. Instead of going, here is the sound, because by the way, he does it on one, so he knows how to sing without scooping. I love that he chooses to scoop. He goes, one special sound, here is the sound, hark to the sound. Oh, it's so enjoyable to listen to. Here we go.
Mrs. of your Morris, soon he'll be gone and grown.
About the sun.
Or worse, all of his own. Think how the years are
flying.
That's like the words of all.
Pretty.
Don't
you stand aside.
Think
this is what you're buying.
One special
sound, here is that sound.
That's how good that is.
Think this is what you're buying. One
special sound. Here is that sound. Lord, it's the sound of love.
Tick it, tick it, tick it, tick it, tick it, tick it, tick. Okay, now we get into some major scoops. Actually, you know what? Before I even say this, I want to just say, Lonnie's not just scooping people. Lonnie's also vibrato. Lonnie means scoop. Price means vibrato. Scooping vibrato. I love Lonnie's vibrato. I first became obsessed with it in Merrily We Roll Along on the word work. That's the story of the way we work. It is so great. Listen to this vibrato. Here we go.
He flies up to California. I discuss him with my son. That's the story of the way we work. Me and
that is an amazing spin. Listen to that spin one more time.
That's the story of the way we work. Me and Franklin Shepard Inc.
Okay, so that's where I first became obsessed with the vibrato. Back to rags. So much scooping, so much vibrato. Let's just listen because I'm obsessed. Here we go.
Mama, I dedicate.
She decides to buy the gramophone. She hears that.
To me, I'll take it.
First vibrato. Here we go.
Come see my magic music machine. Step right on over to your old buddy Ben.
You hear that? To your old. See, that's what I love. He goes, step right on over to your old. He's on the note he began, but then he just ended with, and then he goes to the next one. Step right on over to your old buddy Ben. Ah, I love it. Listen.
Music machine.
Ready?
Step right on over to your old buddy Ben. I'm here to show how American know-how means that you're never lonely again. Gather around, you'll see what I mean. There's room for everyone, you don't have to.
Listen to that. Come on, he scoops and vibratos it on the word don't. Ah, oh, so good.
I'll meet that you're never lonely again. Gather around, you'll see what I mean. There's room for everyone, you don't have to shove. And to proceed, folks, all that we need, folks. One volunteer over here is one right here to bring in the sun.
Oh my God, it's such a great score. God, it's so good. Charles Strauss and Stephen Schwartz. Charles Strauss wrote the music. Stephen Schwartz wrote the lyrics. Lonnie Price added the scoops. Okay, the final thing I want to talk about with scoops and rags is actually, you know, I did another deconstruction about operatic scooping, I call it, like Robert Weed in The Most Happy Fellow. So I want you to hear the ending that's on the recording of Rags. Now, another part of the story you may not know is that Teresa Stratus was the original star of Rags. And there was like a lot of drama going on. All I know is that she did not do the cast album. Julia McGinnis from Fiddler on the Roof did the cast album. She has a great voice. But she does not take the sassy high note at the end of the song, and I do not know why. So I want you to just first hear the ending of the song from the album. There's no high note, and quite frankly, there's not enough scooping for me. So this is the ending of the song Brand New World on the album. Then I'm going to play you the bootleg of the Broadway show with Teresa Stratus, which is phenomenal. Here we go. Okay, this is the ending.
A million miles and landed right in the hall. Cause you see what that man can look at the top. You may be lost and stranded, but we're part of a brand new world.
It's like a weird unison ending. Brand new world. I don't know why there's no harmony there. Okay, so now here is the Broadway version. First of all, the song's to people, I was, no joke, listening to it as I was preparing, fully crying. It's so beautiful, the song, the singing is amazing. Yet again, it's Josh Blake and Teresa Stratus. First, I want you to just hear the really cool modulation at the beginning. It's so satisfying. It's not really modulation. It goes from the relative minor to the major. That's what I kind of figured out myself. I don't know if that's called modulation or not, but listen to this part. Here we go. Okay. This is the bootleg.
Now it belongs to
it's so satisfying to me. You hear the strings going up, and I know her voice is going down, so you think it's not that exciting, but it is, because the strings are going up, and just the way it goes to that major key. Listen one more time.
Now it belongs to you.
I'm sorry. I should tell you what's going on. They both just moved to this country from, Eastern Europe. And they're looking out the window of their apartment at this how do I make you so emotional, so beautiful? They're looking at this whole new country, and they're like, look how different everything is, and they don't really speak English. This is like, they're sung to each other, I think, in a different language, because she says, I can't read those signs. But they're just looking at this brand new world in front of them. Oh, it's so exciting. Listen, I love it.
Where's daddy? Where's that music?
I wanna fly now.
Coming with words I can't read.
All the automobiles they got here.
All these people saying things you don't need.
Everybody's so busy.
This part I love. Busy, it's so busy. But Josh Blake was really young, and it's obviously too low for him, so he has to speak it. I think it's so cute. Listen.
Things you don't need.
Everybody's so busy.
They're so busy. They're making me dizzy.
My head's aching from all this noise here. Everyone hollers and yells.
And the air here is all loaded up with smells. It's such a feeling, like being in hell.
Now remember, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, brand new world. That's how the record ended. Listen how amazing Teresa Stratus ends it, and listen to the scooping she does. Two things I want you to hear. A, she goes for the high note. B, she does not breathe. I don't want to ruin the notes because it's so exciting, but she goes up a fourth, does not breathe between brand new, scoops it, and then breathes the last note. But it's so exciting. Okay. Here we go. Just excited.
It's such a feeling, like we can hurl a million miles and land it right at the heart.
Did you see what I'm riding?
Look at that cart, it even looks and striking. Every part of a brand new world.
Oh my God, isn't it great? Okay, please God, get the Rags album and go see the best worst thing that ever could have happened. Bye.